Hi, this is Anil with a video tutorial for the learning lad on C programming. In this video tutorial, we're gonna write our first ever program in C. First, go and open up your dev C++ compiler and go to file, new, source file. So it's gonna open up a blank file. Go to this file, then save as, and I'm gonna save it in my desktop, and I'm gonna name it first. Then make sure that it has the extension C source files. So save it. So as you can see here, you know, our first.c is ready to go. Before writing the statements in our program, I just want to explain you about the functions. A function is a collection of statements to do some particular task. So in every program, we have to do some task again and again. For example, we have to print something to the screen or to take the input from the keyboard, etc., etc. So the code for all these tasks are grouped into functions, and they are stored in some files which are called header files. To use that functions in our program, we just have to include that header files. So in C, we can include the header files by using a preprocessor directive. A preprocessor is a software which processes our source code, you know, before the compilation. So this preprocessor provides some directives to include the files. We can use hash include, then it's a preprocessor directive, and we're gonna write the file name. In this case, we want to include a file which contains the function for printing something to the screen and taking the input from the keyboard. So that file is called stdio.h. Here, this stdio means that standard input output, and .h is the extension for the header file. So another file we are including is called conio.h. So I'm gonna explain you why we are including this file, you know, later. So when we encounter the statements. So next, we have to write our main function. So every C program begins with a main function. So we can say that, you know, our main function is the entry point of your C program. If you won't write your main function, then your compiler is gonna give an error like, okay, I can't find the main function, so I can't execute your code. So it's gonna be int main, then a pair of parentheses, then a pair of curly braces. So here, this int means that our main function is gonna return some integer value. That's because, you know, every function can return some values. So then, this main is the name of the function. So in every C program, you should have a main function. Within this parenthesis, if you want, you can pass the parameters, you know, that the main function can take. So now we are not passing any parameters, that's why we are leaving it blank. So within this curly braces, we have to write the statements of this main function. Another thing I wanna tell you is, you know, in C, our statement will be executed one after other or in sequential order. In this tutorial, we just want to print something to the screen. So for that purpose, we can use a function provided by this stdio.h header file, and that function is called printf. So within this parenthesis, in double quotes, we have to specify the string we want to print to the screen. So here, I'm gonna write hello learner. So this is it, then add a semicolon. This is important because, you know, every C statement ends with a semicolon. So if you forget to add a semicolon after, you know, C statement, then it's gonna give you an error. So now, as promised here that we are returning some integer value, we have to return it. We're gonna use return keyword to return some value, then we're gonna write 0. So now we're gonna save it, compile it, and run it. So I don't think whether you guys have seen a box just appeared and vanished. So that means that, you know, our program has successfully executed from here to here, and once our statements ended or finished, you know, our program terminated. So the execution speed is so fast that we can see the output. So if you want to see the output, then we have to add a pause in our program. So here, you know, after this printf statement, we want to add a pause so that, you know, whatever we printed here, we can see that. we can add a pause by using one of the methods available from this con.io.h header file, and that function is called getch. This getch function is not specifically made for adding a pause. Actually, by using this function, you can receive a character from your keyboard. But here, when we use this function, you know, it makes the program to wait for something to be inputted from the keyboard. So at that time, you know, we can see the output. So I'm gonna save it, compile it, and run it. So as you can see, we got the output "Hello Learner," and you guys can see a blinking cursor here. You know, it's just waiting for us to enter some key or enter some character from the keyboard. So I'm gonna press a key in my keyboard. You can press any key. Boom, that's it. It just terminated our program. So this is it. This is about the first program in C. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Also like my Facebook page at facebook.com/learninglad. So I see you in the next tutorial.